19:34. One of the teachers of the law came and heard them debating. Noticing that Jesus had given them a good answer, he asked him, "Of all the commandments, which is the most important?" "The most important one," answered Jesus, "is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. The second is this: Love your neighbor as yourself. There is no commandment greater than these." "Well said, teacher," the man replied. "You are right in saying that God is one and there is no other but him. To love him with all your heart and all your understanding and with all of your strength and to love your neighbor as yourself is more important than all burnt offerings and sacrifices." When Jesus saw that he had answered wisely, he said to him, "You are not far from the kingdom of God." And from then on, no one dared ask him any more questions. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
The earth and the entire universe has full capability of blessing blessing more than one path along our journey. I think that God's main desire is that no matter which direction we choose to go, we would invite him into that journey, and that glorifying him is at the center of our hearts and main motivation despite the destination. And maybe the only destination that truly matters is our eternal one. I believe that if God has something specific or somewhere specific that he is calling you to in life, he will get you there. And I want to reassure you that our God is not a God of confusion. I walked the Camino this past summer for spring term, and something we encountered several times was a fork in the path, but each path led to the exact same destination. It was just a different way to get there. Faithfully believing that God will get you there is way better than being overwhelmed and anxious about each step and each decision. God is a way better navigator than we could ever be. Now, this view on our journeys with God does not excuse choosing one direction because you don't want to go the other direction. The goal tonight is not to raise up a bunch of Jonahs. I think that when we do come to those forks in the road, prayerfully considering both options is very important. Obedience and saying yes to God still has to be a top priority. But God can provide more than one good option that are both equally within his will. I'm so passionate about sharing this topic because this is a lesson that God has been teaching me basically my entire time in college thus far. Rewinding back to my senior year of high school, I had no clue what I wanted to do with my life. My answer when people asked me what I was going to be studying in college changed on a weekly basis, and people didn't really take me that seriously. Changed from being a PT or OT to being a teacher, to nursing, to even studying business. I'm pretty sure that I changed my major with UND at least 3 or 4 times before even getting here. I started my first semester as a public health pre-OT major. But in that first semester, I decided that I didn't think OT was really for me. I got a B in history and doubted I would even be able to get into the program, and I didn't even know if I really wanted to go to grad school. I liked public health, but decided I wanted to be more hands-on with patient care. So I changed my major to nursing, still not really convinced that's actually what I wanted to do. Time went on, and I was simultaneously discerning a couple different opportunities to be a missionary intern over the approaching summer. I decided to go to Haiti, where I had been the previous summer on a mission trip with my youth group right after graduating. I left for Haiti on June 7th, and funny enough, received my acceptance letter into the nursing program the day before I left. In Haiti, I was one of 9 summer interns in charge of helping lead mission teams like the one I had been on, and helping form relationships within the community. My time there was one of the most amazing times in my life, full of spiritual growth and maturity. And for one of the first times in my life, I had people praising my strength, telling me they looked up to me, and that I had a confidence about me that allowed them to feel safe when we were in the community and doing different things. I also had people telling me that they could see me here long term, and I didn't disagree with them. Remember, I had no idea what I wanted to do with my life. For the first time, I was a part of something that I could see myself waking up and doing every day, in a place that had become my second home. Quickly, the thought of going back and starting nursing school didn't seem like enough. When I came back home, I basically decided I probably wasn't going to continue with school, and that I was going to join a 3-year missionary training program in Haiti. And I had pretty much already been accepted into that. To make a long story short, things kind of fell apart in the first few weeks of being back home. I had lost a portion of my financial aid and didn't know if I could afford to go back to school, even if I wanted to. And my dad, who was an alcoholic, much of when I was growing up, started drinking again while I was gone and got arrested for DUI at the end of July. All of these things that seemed to be happening all at once made it really hard to listen to God and his voice seemed like it was lost in the mud of everything else happening. I had about one leg still in the drawer to go back to school, but three-fourths of me was already on my way back to Haiti. But I had a couple of really important people speak into my life about how much more I could do as a missionary with a degree in nursing, and how many more doors could potentially be opened in the future. They weren't telling me these things to talk me out of moving to Haiti, but giving me a perspective that I wasn't thinking about. I had also sought out the opinion of another missionary mobilizer, and she told me most of their missionaries have college degrees, and she told me how much of an impact I could potentially have with my peers by saying I want to be a nurse as a platform for sharing Jesus. So with everything else going on, I decided that the best thing for me at that time was to go back to school. I was still nervous and apprehensive and struggled with believing that this is what I wanted to do most of that first semester of nursing school. When second semester rolled around, me and one of my closest friends, who was also having similar feelings, ended up in a clinical group together. Every morning on our way to the hospital, we decided that we would pray together about receiving clarity from God, asking Him to be with us, and allowing us to be the hands and feet of Jesus while we were caring for our patients. We shared our joys and struggles together, and I don't think either of us will ever forget our first patient and how much she taught us about how meaningful providing dignity to someone through feeding them, bathing them, and just being present with them can be. Being a nurse is not always glamorous, but throughout that semester, God provided me with more than enough affirmation to show me that I was in the right place, bringing Him glory and making a difference in the lives of my patients. Almost every patient I had told me how thankful they were for me, how much me being with them meant to them, and telling me that I was going to make a great nurse. I carried a lot of anxiety and guilt with me for a long time about being afraid I had went the wrong direction. But I chose to invite God on the journey with me and allow Him to speak into my life. God will never leave us, and Genesis 3:8 tells us that God has been walking beside us from the very beginning. Fast forward to being over halfway through the nursing program, and I couldn't be happier with where I am and the opportunities that are in the future. I know that I get to meet people where they are and be a reflection of Christ in some of their most vulnerable moments. However, I believe that if I would have chosen to move to Haiti for 3 years, God would have blessed that path as well. And I don't believe that God needs me to be getting my college degree so that I can be used by Him. And maybe I will end up as a missionary in Haiti or some other country at some point in my life, but I believe that if that's where God chooses to put me, He will get me there. Inviting God into the story is far more important than where that takes us. I know that I can't possibly be the only one in the room who has struggled with decisions and the fear of being outside of God's will. I may be the only one here who has nearly dropped out of college to move to a third world country for 3 years, but that doesn't matter. Whether you end up in a career that has nothing to do with your major, or were split between two amazing schools but chose to come here, fill in the blank with your struggle. I'm sure we've all been here to some degree. I pray that you would begin to be able to see God working in your daily life and how the journey that you're on is bringing glory to Him. And most of all, I pray that you can find rest in this. I think that God's will can be simplified into the scripture that we heard in the beginning. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. And love your neighbor as yourself. There is no commandment greater than these. God's will is about loving God and loving others. This is possible in any job or place we may find ourselves. Let God take care of the rest. So tonight, I want you to ask yourselves, do you love God with all that you are and all that you have? And do you love those around you as you love yourself? If you can answer yes to these, you're living within the will of God.